Joe Petruba here from New Jersey 101.5, and I am very excited to be sitting here today with a guy who I actually spoke to once before. It was a few months before he was a college graduate, but now he is, as of May 2014. Eric LeGrand, how are you?
Doing well. How are you?
I'm doing just fine. And we're here today because your fifth annual 5K, A Walk to Believe, is going to be taking place June 7th, correct?
Yes, it is. It's going to be June 7th. It's our fifth annual one. It's taking place at High Point Solutions Stadium, which is a Rutgers football stadium right on Bush campus. It's a 5K walk slash run this year that we're adding to it. And it's fun. You know, you come out there, you have your walkers, you have your runners. And then also after you get done, we have a barbecue, you know, with a bunch of our sponsors and everything. And everyone comes over for a barbecue slash tailgate.
Nice.
Yeah, so, cool. You know, after, you know, get your runner walking, you come over, you take pictures, you know, bring out some of my teammates too, you know, some of my NFL guys that are in the NFL now, and my just, you know, friends from my team, and, you know, hang out, take pictures,
very
sign
cool.
autographs. It's going to be a good time.
Awesome. I was doing some research, and last year you raised over $65,000 in one day.
Yes.
At last year's 5K.
Yes, and that was a big goal. Our goal was $52,000, and we shattered it, you know, thanks to our sponsors and everyone that came out that day. And this year, I have my own personal goal. I want to get six figures. I want to hit over 100K this year.
You hear that?
Now, that's my personal goal.
Let's make this happen.
We need to make that happen. I'm hopefully with the sponsors and everything, and everyone that comes out to walk.
Awesome. So not only has your foundation come a long way, but, I mean, you have as well. You've just made amazing strides in your recovery. Doctors said you'd never be able to walk again, eat solid food again, that you'd be on a ventilator the rest of your life, and here you are.
Yeah.
I was doing a little bit of reading about your recovery, and the one thing that kept coming up, which I don't know a lot about, but I would like to learn about, and I think our audience would like to learn about, is muscle memory.
Yes, well, muscle memory has actually helped me out a lot because, you know, a lot of people you see with this injury after, you know, their muscles aren't moving and they're not moving around a lot, you know, their body, you get a lot of muscle atrophy, and you know, a lot of people become skin and bones or real tight. With me, since I believe I was an athlete before, I was, you know, really, you know, strong, you know, lifting weights all the time and everything. A lot of my muscle has came back, you know, and it's actually keeping me in good shape into what I am now. You know, I could actually drop a few pounds after eating so good and everything, but my muscle memory, I'm not skin and bones at all. I'm actually
right.
pretty solid and everything. So this muscle memory has actually helped me a lot, do a lot of more physical therapy because I can, you know, do a lot more, especially when I get thrown around a little bit on the mat and stuff. And, you know, they're not worried about breaking me at all.
Right, right. Now, where in your therapy, where are you now? When you're going there during the week, what is your routine?
Well, I actually started a new routine. I actually was walking on the Neuro Recovery Network treadmill, which is a grant from the Christopher Dana Reed Foundation. I believe I walked for 500 sessions on that treadmill, and I've regained back so much, you know, from being able to walk on that treadmill, from my trunk balance to muscles in my back, you know, muscles in my shoulders, mm-hmm. my neck, and, you know, being able to sit up on my own, things like that, getting some twitches in my fingers, moving my body around more and more. It all came back from that walking on that treadmill, and I kind of, you know, hit a little plateau area for a while, so I'm trying to mix it up now, and I'm actually working on my standing frame, just getting in the standing frame three times a week at therapy and trying to maintain my blood pressure balance because with my level of injury, it's hard to maintain a good blood pressure as you stand up. You get real lightheaded and real dizzy for the longer you stand up, and I actually just broke my record, you know, about a week ago. I was standing up, and all of a sudden, I sat up for 36 minutes without getting dizzy at all.
Really?
Which came out of nowhere. Which for the day before I did, I believe 12 minutes, and I, you know, I was going back down to
you
reset.
You tripled that.
Yeah, and then all of a sudden 36. If I had to go to my next session of therapy, that's the only reason why I came down. So who knows how long I could have been standing?
That is incredible. I have a couple of rapid fire questions I wanted to throw your way. Who's your favorite musician?
Lil Wayne.
Lil Wayne. Genre hip hop.
Hip hop, R&B, everything.
So for hip hop, top five dead or alive?
Top five dead or alive. Gotta definitely go with Biggie, Tupac, Jay-Z, Kendrick Lamar, and Lil Wayne back in his prime, baby.
Have you heard Kendrick's new album?
I have listened to it a little bit. You know, I'm trying to get into it because some of my friends are huge Kendrick Lamar fans, and I'm trying to get into it, but I'm a big Lil Wayne Drake guy, so
cool.
I listen to that a lot more, but Kendrick, he spits some knowledge.
Yeah, he does. That's one of those albums, by the way, where you need to listen front to back in one sitting. I know you're a busy
guy. That's what my friends, you sound just like all my friends. Yeah. They all tell me. You have to sit down and listen to from one to the always to the end.
Yeah, there's jazz and spoken word. It's mm-hmm. it's incredible. But since you're from Jersey, and this comes up a lot on the mm-hmm. station, if you had to choose one, Bruce or Bon Jovi?
Living on a Prayer. How could I go against that? You know? That's all right. That's a Jovi right there. So
favorite TV show?
Favorite TV show? SportsCenter.
SportsCenter? Okay. Sitcoms. I hear you talking a lot about Entourage.
I am an Entourage guy. I love Entourage and Game of Thrones.
Who would be the one cast member that you can relate to most?
I think I'm the Vinny Chase. Vinny Chase, yeah, with all my, you know, I got my friends and everything around me, or my, you know, business partners are always trying to make moves and work something around me, and I'm the one who pretty much calls the shots. He does, all right, let's try this or let's try that. So I'm the Vinny Chase, but Johnny Drama might be my favorite. He's hilarious. He's just watching. Oh, man.
Yeah, no, he's... Some days I feel like Drama. Some days I feel like Ari. You know, I mean... I understand. It's all about the mindset. You're a Broncos fan.
Yes,
I am. I know that well. The last time we spoke, Peyton Manning was about 6 days away from being in his first Super Bowl with the Broncos. So now I'm going to ask you, a year and a half later, he's 39 years old. Can he still do it?
I believe he can. I believe he can. You know, last season he played the last four games hurt, and everyone was asking, what's going on with Peyton? What's going on with Peyton? He had a torn quad, and he played through it. So, you know, that gave me a little sigh of relief, and I still think he got it. You know, he still had a great season this past year, even though he broke my heart 2 years ago, and then I wish they would have made it this year, but they didn't. But third, you know, hopefully, you know, now this is going to be the fourth time. So, can't say third time's a charm. I'm hoping we can do it. Either way, I'm still going to be supporting my Broncos.
Gotta believe. Favorite place to visit on the Jersey Shore?
Ooh.
It could be a town or a specific beach or a place.
Well, I used to always go to Belmar growing up as a kid, and I've been now going to the Jersey Shore. I'm always at either a DJ's, a bar A, or if I'm a headliner. So cool. Belmar is my spot.
Awesome. And this is going to be really random, but this is something that we argue about on the show almost monthly. North and South Jersey.
Oh, man.
Where is the line?
And there's Central Jersey, and I truly believe I live in the northern part of Central Jersey, the very northern part, last part of Central Jersey, okay. Because you have Middlesex County, and then you have Union County, which I believe is North Jersey, and I connect with Rahway, Avenel, Union County, Middlesex County. So I say I'm the last part of Central Jersey. I always go the mountains of North Jersey, the Northwest, South Jersey, is all the farms and stuff, you know. And then you mix a little beach when you come to the East Coast. But then you got the civilized Central where we got everything.
The civilized Central. Civilized like
Central where we got everything. We don't got mountains and hills, or we don't have farmlands. We got just people and just a bunch of people. People and a bunch of just things that are civilized.
Yeah, exactly. And a lot of traffic.
Yes, yes.
Has there been any one coach or athlete, either at the pro or collegiate level, who, following your injury, whose advice stood out to you among the rest?
You know, I live my life by a definition I learned in college. It is what I learned from Coach Shiano, who also got it from John Wooden. And it's the definition of success. And it's the peace of mind you get knowing you did everything you could to be the best you can be. If you know at the end of the day you gave it your all at something, then you're your own definition of success. And you should be able to lay your head down at night on that pillow and be able to sleep easy because you know that you gave it your all.
That's awesome advice. That's about as good as it gets.
Exactly.
I just read your second Players Tribune article, which, by the way, I just, for a second, leave it to Derek Jeter, who, after being the king of New York for almost 20 years, his first off-the-field endeavor is something that sports journalism has been needing for years. But your articles, both of them, have been fascinating. In your newest article entitled Jermaine... you talk about what-ifs. And how often do you play the what-if game?
I'm glad you asked me that. You know, the what-if game, people ask me that all the time. Like, well, you know, how do you not say the what-ifs? Like, well, the what-if you could have been in the NFL? What if you could have been winning the Super Bowl? You know, what if this or what if that? And, you know, I don't play too much. Of course, every day it creeps into your mind, like, what if this, what if that, especially when things get tough. But I always come back to the great things that I'm doing right now. And, you know, the people that I have in my life, you know, how can I, what if all the things that are going on right now, like being able to write a book or being able to do those articles with the Players Tribune, being able to do the therapy, travel all over the place, have a great family, have a great girlfriend, things like that. How can I what if that stuff? Because I wouldn't have had that stuff if it wasn't for this.
Exactly. Life's just crazy. Mm-hmm. You know, you just got to live it one day at a time. And I know you are aware of this kid, Mikey Nichols from Monroe, suffered a very traumatic injury. And it's been said a couple of times that, you know, your advice to him has helped him get through, you know, because he's just going through the early stages of recovery. And your advice and you being there, because you've been there now, mm-hmm. you've experienced this for almost 5 years now. At the end of the day, when it's all said and done, how do you want to be remembered?
I want to be remembered for someone who's never gave up. Look to me as a hero. Look to me as someone that people could always lean on. You know, I consider myself very strong mentally, physically, everything. You know, I just, you know, I really believe that God put me here to help other people. And, you know, other people's struggles that sometimes that they can't deal with, or they look to me as something like, wow, you got to deal with this, you got to deal with that. But I kind of just like brush it off to the side. It doesn't bother me that much. So, you know, I always say you got to appreciate the things that you do have and don't focus on the things that you don't. If it's something that you want, then you work your butt off to go and get it. And that's what I truly believe in. That's what I try to pass on to other people. You know, you got to take every day as a blessing. You know, nothing's ever guaranteed. Anything could happen in this world. You just got to be appreciative for everything that's around you. Some people are in worse situations than others, but be happy for what you do have. And Mike, if you listen to this, I got them J's for you.
Once again, the 5th annual A Walk to Believe 5K will be June 7th, High Point Solutions Stadium in Piscataway. Last year raised over $65,000 in one day. We're going to try to beat that, right?
Try to beat that. My personal goal, 100K.
And if you want to see more of Eric LeGrand, Twitter and Instagram, at Eric LeGrand 52, correct?
At Eric LeGrand 52. And all my websites are teamlegrand.org. Or you can go to www.awalktobelieve.org to sign up for the walk, for the 5K walk and 5K run this year.
This is Joe Vitruba for New Jersey 101.5. Thank you, Eric, so much for joining us.
Thank you for having me.